Today, we are going to look at a very unusual bird, the Hoatzin of South America. As usual, a document with the sources for the images used, along with the research papers I found useful, will be included in the description of this video. The Hoatzin is the only surviving member of the order Opisthocomiformes. This order only has one family in it, Opisthocomidae. This long scientific name comes from Greek, meaning long hair behind, referring to the large crest on the Hoatzin's head. It is unknown if its extinct relatives also sported similar crests, as such a thing is difficult to tell from fossils. The exact placement of the Hoatzins and their extinct relatives has been debated by scientists for a long time. They are extremely different to other living species of birds, with many unique adaptations, but this makes them tricky to determine what other birds are their closest living relatives. They are widely agreed to be somewhere in the clade of birds known as the Neoaves. This is not really surprising, since that clade includes almost all living birds, only excluding ratites like the kiwi and ostrich. So, where is it within the Neoaves? Well, I have no idea, and looking at the studies, it appears that no one else does either. There are 7 superorders in Neoaves, that is, clades containing many different orders. The Hoatzins are one of the 3 orders that are by themselves, not belonging in any of the superorders. Everyone agrees on those facts, but since 2014, so in the last 10 years, there have been 9 different proposals for how these groups are related to each other. That number includes 2 studies from this year alone, as of May 2024 when I am recording this. Even just looking at these 2 most recent studies, they still disagree with the relationships proposed by the other. Part of the reason for this confusion is that it is still disputed which parts of the genetics is the most important to determine the relationships between different groups. To complicate matters even further, birds are believed to have massively diversified over a very short period of time, only about 2 million years, 65 to 67 million years ago. While 2 million years may seem like a lot, this is nothing when talking about a geological or evolutionary time frame. It is not a coincidence either that this time frame coincides with the extinction event that wiped out the non-avian dinosaurs at the end of the Cretaceous period, 66 million years ago. But this means that all lineages of birds are actually fairly closely related to each other, so it is hard to split them apart and work out which the most closely related groups are. So where does that leave the placement of Hoatzins? To put it mildly, it is disputed, but I will go through the phylogeny proposed by the most recent study, released in May 2024. In this study, Stiller et al. Argue that most of the diversification of the modern-day birds occurred after the extinction event. The only groups of Neoaves that they believe predate this, and therefore are the oldest lineages in our phylogeny today, are the flamingos and grebes, and the pigeons, bustards and cuckoos. I do have a video dedicated to grebes, so check that out if you want to learn more about that particular group. Moving on past the extinction event, birds began to diversify massively, likely to fill in the gaps left by the extinct groups such as the dinosaurs and pterosaurs. It was at this point that most of the so-called core land birds split off from the others. This is a diverse group, including hawks, kingfishers, parrots, passerines, falcons and many others. The remaining lineage is split into 2 clades. In the first one, we have the hummingbirds, swifts and nightjars in one group, and the tropic birds alongside the so-called cool water birds in the other. Like the land birds from earlier, the cool water birds are a diverse group, including cormorants, penguins, herons and many others. The last clade is the one we are actually looking at today, as we start with Opisthocomiformes, containing the Hoatzins and its extinct relatives. The closest living relatives of the Hoatzin then are the cranes and rails in the order Gruiformes, and the shorebirds in Charadriaformes. The birds included in the order of cranes and rails should be fairly self-explanatory, but the shorebirds include seagulls, terns, plovers, stilts and sandpipers, along with other closely related species. Focusing in on the Opisthocomiformes, there is only a single family in the order, Opisthocomidae. The Hoatzin may be its only living member, but there are a number of extinct genera in this family too. Only 4 genera have been definitively included here, but a couple of others have been tentatively suggested, although most of these were later debunked. For example, Foropinarium, an extinct bird that lived in Wyoming about 48 million years ago, has been suggested as being closely related to the Hoatzin. However, in 2018, a genetic analysis of this species suggested that it was actually an early Turaco. So, while its exact placement is still uncertain, it is likely that Foropinarium was not a close relative of the Hoatzin. Another extinct bird, sometimes included with the Hoatzins, is Onycopteryx simpsoni. This bird from Argentina is only known from a partial tarsometatarsus fragment, which is one of the bones in the foot. While this does have some similarities to the Hoatzin, most scientists are reluctant to group them together based on such little evidence. With only one living species, it is difficult to determine what characterizes the Opisthocomiformes as a whole and what features are unique to the Hoatzin. From the fossil species that have been included in this order, it is clear that the structure of the bones in their shoulder joint is one distinguishing feature, but it is really hard to give any more information than that. One interesting thing is that despite modern-day Hoatzins being endemic to South America, the order did not originate on that continent. This can be seen when looking at the most distantly related genus included in this family. This is Namibiavis sinuti, which, if you could not guess from the name, were found in Namibia in Africa. They lived during the late Miocene, about 17 million years ago, and they were originally classified as being related to the Sirriamus, a group of ground-dwelling birds whose living species are also restricted to South America. Namibiavis was eventually distinguished from this group, largely based on the structure of their shoulder joint, and was instead identified as an early Hoatzin. The fossils in Namibiavis, along with all of the other extinct Hoatzins, share some similarities with the modern-day Hoatzin, indicating that they had an enlarged crop and so were poor flyers. We will look at these features more closely when we get to the modern Hoatzin, as most of the information about these features come from the only living example. Protoazin parisiensis has the oldest fossils known in this family. These fossils were found in France and have been dated to the late Eocene, about 34 million years ago. But this raises many questions about where Hoatzins originated and how they dispersed to South America. Despite being quite a bit older, you may notice the phylogeny listed Namibiavis as the earliest lineage. This is simply because the fossils we do have of Protoazin have more similarities to modern Hoatzins than the fossils we have of Namibiavis. This raises questions about how Hoatzins dispersed into their present-day range in South America. The discovery of Protoazin strongly suggests that Hoatzins originated in Africa, dispersed to Europe, and from there probably made it over the Atlantic into North America, and then down to South America. However, if this is the case, then we are missing some crucial stages. For a start, we have yet to find any evidence of Hoatzins in North America. We also have yet to find older fossils in Africa, as you might expect if this hypothesis is correct. Alternatively, Hoatzins could have colonized South America directly from Africa, bypassing the problem of lacking fossils in North America. But this would make Protoazin an offshoot, which still doesn't quite fit the evidence we have. As you can see, there are theories about how Hoatzins evolved and dispersed, but we simply don't have enough evidence to conclusively answer the question. The last of the extinct Hoatzins is Hoazinavis lacustris. This is the only fossil genus found in South America. It is known to have lived in Brazil about 22 to 24 million years ago. Its fossils look very similar to the modern Hoatzin, although it is smaller. In fact, Hoazinavis is the smallest known of any Hoatzin, living or extinct. Due to the fragmentary nature of the remains that have been found so far, only a few wing and breast bones. It is hard to give more information about this species. Finally, it is time to look at the only living member of this order, this family, and its genus. This is the Hoatzin, Opisthocomus Hoazin. Its common name is derived from Nahuatl, a language of the Aztecan language family. They used Hoatzin or Hoazin to refer to several hen-sized birds within the Valley of Mexico in the 17th century, a word that was also briefly picked up and used indiscriminately by early naturalists. This word was eventually taken to refer specifically to the Hoatzin we are talking about today. It also has some other names, such as stink bird or reptile bird. These are names which will make sense once you start to learn a bit more about this bird. In Guyana, where it is the national bird, it is sometimes also known as the Kanhei pheasant due to it being found along the Kanhei River. As you might expect, given how distantly related it is to other birds, the Hoatzin is extremely unique. It is a medium-sized bird, being about 65 centimeters or 26 inches long. It has a long neck and a small head, with very distinctive coloration along the length of its body. It has blue skin on its face around its eye. Its neck is streaked black and white, while its wings are a reddish-brown color. It has a large spiky crest on its head. This crest is always upright and cannot be raised or lowered, unlike crests in many other birds. Hoatzins live in the Amazon and Orinoco basins in South America. They favor wetland forest, often being found in swamps or mangroves. They have some features that seem very primitive compared to other birds, and are possibly a throwback to their dinosaur ancestors. However, I have brought up the phylogeny again so you can see they are not an early branch of the birds. They are right in the middle and split off from the other lineages well after the ratites and most of the land birds. So they are not some primitive lineage, but have instead evolved to regain some features known in few living birds. The first of these features is that Hoatzin chicks have claws, a fact that has led to their name as the reptile bird. They grow two claws on each wing, and use these along with their feet to scramble along tree branches without falling off. Hoatzin nests are typically in trees overhanging bodies of water, so as a defensive strategy, the young will dive into this water to escape predators, and they can then use their claws to climb back out and get back up to their nest. These clawed wings might make you think of something like Archaeopteryx, a rather famous bird-like dinosaur that lived around 150 million years ago. This was well before the modern birds evolved, so the similarity has several explanations. While it could be convergent evolution, where two distantly related animals evolved similar features due to a similar niche, in this case, it is more likely an example of autapomorphy. Autapomorphy is a distinctive feature that is unique to a specific lineage, but is not seen in closely related species. As a result, it is not useful in determining how closely related different groups are, but it could be an explanation for something like the clawed wing of young Hoatzin, since we know their distant ancestors also had something similar. In the example of the Hoatzin, given how long ago Archaeopteryx lived, it, or another dinosaur like it, could have been a direct ancestor to the modern birds. The genes to grow claws, therefore, could still be in the genome of birds today. This gene would theoretically be inactive or lost in most modern birds, but for some reason it was reactivated in the Hoatzin lineage, despite its closest living relatives not showing the trait. I should point out that young birds with claws are not completely unique to Hoatzins. They share this, along with some other surprising similarities, with the turricos in the family Musophagidae. I should stress that turricos are not closely related to Hoatzins. Musophagidae is in the clade also containing cuckoos and bustards, which is one of the superorders in Neoaves that is believed to have diversified before the Cretaceous extinction event. Hoatzins, as we discussed earlier, diversified after this pivotal event, and so are much more closely related to most other birds, and especially to cranes, rails, and shorebirds. Anyway, returning to the Hoatzins, they are also known for having a digestive system that is unique among birds and is actually reminiscent of that seen in ruminants like cows. This time, it definitely is an example of convergent evolution. Hoatzins are primarily folivores, eating mostly leaves, although they will eat fruit and flowers on occasion. This gives them a similar issue to grazing mammals, as they need a way to break down tough and cellulose-heavy vegetation, and cellulose is notoriously difficult for animals to digest. As they are birds, Hoatzins do not have teeth. However, the edges of their beak are serrated, allowing them to cut leaves into smaller portions before swallowing them. Smaller pieces allow the fermentation and digestion process to occur quicker. This is just the first step. In birds, food is sent to the crop before it is digested. In Hoatzins, their crop is unusually large and is divided into two chambers. Through muscles and the calloused walls of their crop, Hoatzins actually use this to help with the digestive process, instead of simply being a storage area. The food then travels to their gut, where Hoatzins have specialized bacteria to further break down the vegetation. This entire process takes around 45 hours from first eating the food to excreting it. Similar to ruminants, methane gas is produced as a waste product of the fermentation, which the bird expels through burping. With only a total weight of about 700 grams, hoatzins are the smallest known animals with foregut fermentation. For comparison, the lower weight limit for this in mammals is about 3 kilograms. The large crop hoatzins have does come at a cost. The crop is so large that it has displaced their flight muscles. In most birds, flight muscles are attached to their keel, a specialized extension of their breastbone. This is still true in hoatzins, but the entire keel and their flight muscles as well have moved to make room for their crop. As a result, they are weak flyers. They are slow, not able to maneuver themselves well if targeted by an aerial predator, and cannot fly for very long. To compensate for their poor flying, hoatzins have other defensive strategies to deal with predators. The young try to hide among the foliage, but, as I mentioned earlier, will dive into water to get away if needed, and they are very strong swimmers. The adults tend to hide or use vocalizations and spreading their wings to appear more intimidating. When looking after chicks, adults will fly around while making a lot of noise to divert the predator's attention away from the young and give them a chance to escape. Hoatzins breed during the rainy season, although the exact timing for this can vary across their range. They nest in small colonies. As mentioned earlier, these nests are built on branches overhanging bodies of water. They construct the nest out of sticks, and the female lays 2 to 3 eggs in it. When they hatch, the young are fed by the adult, regurgitating already fermented vegetation. Young remain in the nest for up to 21 days after hatching, and become sexually mature after their first year. In the wild, hoatzins can typically live up to 14 or 15 years, but this can be doubled in captivity, with some living to be as old as 30. Hoatzins are not hunted for food by humans, as they are reported to taste bad. In addition to this, hoatzins also smell very bad as a result of the fermentation process they use to digest leaves. As a result, they have mostly been left alone by humans, although their eggs have sometimes been collected, particularly in Brazil. Perhaps due to this lack of human persecution, hoatzins are classified as least concerned by the IUCN. While it is unknown how many hoatzin remain in the wild, it is believed that their population is slowly declining. This is largely due to the massive deforestation occurring in the Amazon rainforest, so habitat loss would be the primary threat for hoatzins. Another effect humans are having on the hoatzin is actually through ecotourism, specifically on nesting success. Unfortunately, studies have shown that nesting sites that are visited by many humans, such as those involved in ecotourism, are negatively impacted. Chicks were noticeably more stressed, gained weight slower, and had higher mortality than those at undisturbed nesting sites. At least adult hoatzins appeared to have become used to the presence of humans in these areas, and so were not affected by ecotourism. This means that hatching success is the same, since hoatzins do not abandon their nest due to human intruders, as they do not consider them predators. However, the effect it has on the chicks and chick survival is concerning in areas with a high proportion of nests affected by ecotourism. Unlike the adults, the chicks do not have time to become habituated to human observers, and so still engage in anti-predator behaviours, using energy that could otherwise be used for growing. Another explanation for the higher mortality actually poses the opposite. Chicks cannot become used to humans because if they do, they are more likely to become prey for one of the many rainforest predators. Either way, the effect is the same. Nesting hoatzins are negatively impacted by ecotourism. I hope you enjoyed this video. Hoatzins are fascinating birds and are completely unique in the animal kingdom. No other living species has feathers in flight, but also grows claws and has an ungulate-like digestion system. Thank you for listening, and feel free to suggest another group of animals you want to see me cover in the comments.